The floors of Tokyo Ho, down in London town Chicago, with the record selection and the mirror's reflection, I'm a dancing with myself. There's no one else as I hide in the crowded lonely night. Yes, to wait so long for my love vibration, and I'm dancing with myself. Oh, dancing with myself. Dancing with myself. When there's nothing to lose and there's nothing to prove. Dancing with myself. It's all over the world, and there's every type of girl. But your empty eyes seem to pass me by. I'm dancing with myself. So let's take another drink, and it'll give you time to begin. 'Cause if I had the chance, I'd have served you to dance. Oh, dancing with myself. Dancing with myself. If I had the chance, I'd ask you to dance. Dancing with myself. Oh, oh, oh. The world. I see every type of girl, but your empty eyes seem to pass me by. I'm even dancing with myself. So you sip another drink, and it'll give you time to think. 'Cause if I had the chance, I'd serve you to die. Oh, oh, I'm dancing with myself. Oh, oh, I'm dancing with myself. If I had the chance, I'd ask you to dance. If I had the chance, I'd ask you to dance. If I had the chance, I'd ask Serbia to dance. Oh, 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 oh. Evil machine. The chance at a Serbia to die. Oh, oh, I'm dancing with myself. Oh, oh, I'm dancing with myself. If I had the chance, I'd ask you to dance. If I had the chance, I'd ask you to dance. If I had the chance, I'd ask Serbia to die. Oh, 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 oh. You see my leather's all wet, yeah, gonna sweat, yeah, gonna sweat, 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 sweat. With myself, dancing with myself, myself, I'm alright. tune with my sin.
It's really a great honor for me and the entire crew. We enjoyed in your first performance. This is supposed to be the interview after the concert, but suddenly the rain happened and you decided to move your concert. So
how did you feel about it? Well, we just knew the weather was going to be so much better today, and it was thunder and lightning last night. I just hated the idea of anybody seriously getting hurt in the audience, let alone on the stage, because who knows what can happen. So. We were here today to do this television show, so we could move it to tonight, so fantastic.
It's going to be fun. I want to say thanks in the name of the audience and everybody in Serbia, because it doesn't happen very often that people are so nice to us and that they move their obligations in order to make things comfortable for us. This is the third time that you perform in Serbia, and both times was amazing. So can they expect something similar tonight?
I hope so, yes. I hope our standards haven't fallen since then. I don't think so.
Yeah, okay. How long it lasts for you? Yeah! How many years you're on the stage? It's a long time, yeah?
Yes, 38
years. And you're not tired yet?
No.
Okay, you can save it. You can save it for yourself. I was preparing myself a little bit for this interview, and I was doing research about your history, and it's very interesting. You've been going to very tough high schools, and then you went to the university the first year, and then you left it in 1976, if I'm right, and you decided to join the people that were the fans of Sex Pistols. So you started as a punk, but then you become a rocker and one of the best in the history of the rock and roll. So how do you see this change between the punk and the rock? And what happened to you to change your
style? Yes, I started out in a punk rock group. Generation X is the first group I was in. And it was just really that when it just came to an end about 1980, Generation X came to an end, we broke up. And I didn't really have any other option but to carry on my own. And
you went to New York, yeah?
I decided, yes, I moved to New York to get a fresh start, because in England, you can end up propping up a bar, which could be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Just drinking yourself stupid can be fantastic.
But I did it a few times.
I was a little bit too young to retire, so I thought if I went to New York and started again, a lot of the groups I liked came from New York, the Velvet Underground, New York Dolls, and there's a lot of punk rock groups in New York, and I just thought it'd be a great way to start again, and it all went on from there. I met Steve Stevens, my guitar player.
He was on the stage with you
today,
yeah.
And we started to write songs together, and that's what you've been hearing.
Okay, let's see one of the clips from the beginning. It's very fine for me to see it, if you agree, of course.
Yeah.
It'll be on the screen there. Generation X, yeah?
That's me with Generation X. Yeah.
Wild Youth?
Yeah, 1977, yes.
So how did you feel at that moment? Did you assume that you're going to become such a legend?
No, I had no idea. I mean, it was a lot of fun. I mean, that's really what it was all about. We weren't doing it for any other reason than for its own sake. Because England at that time, it was very depressed. The economy was terrible, terribly depressed, and that was our way of having fun. We just decided there weren't any jobs. If there aren't any jobs, create your own job. Just do the thing you loved. And music was what we loved, and we sort of started the punk rock movement because of it, really, because of the depression in the economy. And
yes. There is something specific about you. You have a strange name that you gave to yourself from your own reasons. Then you were a punk man that said that he's influenced by Beatles and Rolling Stones instead of saying about the Clash and the Sex Pistols. Then you published the first album that was done on the Macintosh computer in 1993, and it was a revolution in that time. So you always do something that nobody did before you. Is this your main motivation, to be different and to be number one all the time?
Well, I think that's the thing. You've got to keep yourself motivated, keep yourself excited, and that's one way of doing it, is always kind of testing the boundaries of what you're doing. I mean, it's great today to play a couple of our greatest hits, really, but it's fantastic to kind of, you know, stretch the borders of what you're doing and go into uncharted land. And I think we've got a new record coming out in October, and it's still very Billy Idol, but I think at the same time we've managed to extend the formula, as people say.
It's slightly modern, yeah?
Yeah, it's got a lot. I think hopefully people will still see it's very much connected to what I've done before, but it just has a little bit more of a... We've got some different instrumentation on it. There's actually some strings on it, and I hope people like it. So, but I think that's the point. You just keep yourself excited by, pushing the boundaries. Yeah.
Okay.
Trying to make an album with the computers, where I'd never done that before. That was exciting.
It was a great idea for that time. Nobody did it before.
Yeah, it was very exciting.
Now everybody do it.
That's
even
the
those
way
DJs,
of recording
that's
today.
The only way they do it.
It was my way of learning the new way to record.
There is something very specific about your video clips for your songs. When I was a kid, my first sexual experiences came from watching your video clips, you know? This is my honesty moments, you know.
So,
I don't want to ask you how did you come to that idea, because it's very obvious, but that was also different from the others. And do you think that this erotic moment in your video clips was very important, and does erotics go together with rock and roll?
Well, it was one thing about punk rock was it wasn't so intersex. It was kind of a little bit non-sexual, actually, in a way. I mean, which is cool. But when I started to make my own solo music, it was fun to... I don't know, the 80s seemed like it was going to be a lot more fun, and we were still living in that kind of the era before AIDS and everything, when there was a lot of free sex going on, and it was great to celebrate that.
That's why they call it good old times, you know?
Yeah, that's right. And it was just my way of being me, really. I was just being me more, you know. I could be me more because now I was my own solo artist. It was all about me, and it was good fun to put that in. We always had a lot of ladies in the audience, and it's nice to tickle their fancy, as we'd say in English.
It is, yeah. You can see their faces, you know. They're like, ah. So, okay, I want to show the clip now.
That was very important for me when I was age 11 or 12, maybe 13, not more than 16. So if you agree.
Okay, let's have a look.
Rock the cradle. Ooh.
know that today it looks pretty much normal, but in the 80s, you know, for us, the kids, it was very... Where did you find all these girls? Is there an agency or something?
No, they just gravitate towards me. I don't know what it is.
I knew I was supposed to be a rock star, not a TV host, you know. That's my biggest mistake in life.
We have a question for the audience tonight. The lady in the white shirt, she wanted to know, what do you think, which of your songs would be most appropriate for some striptease act?
Well, Flesh and Fantasy.
Flesh and Fantasy.
Okay. So she can go home and practice a little bit. Speaking about the ladies, we had a lot of stars here in the studio, but only you and Brian Ferry managed to make all these women to come and to do during your singing, you know? What do you think is the secret? Is it only your appearance or some energy that you have?
Hopefully it's beyond my appearance. Hopefully it is a touch of the energy I have, or we just tried to make the song sensual.
I think that you're managing to go to their heart, which I never managed to do in my life. But do you think that maybe I should say the lyrics of your songs or something like that? Do you have an advice for me, how to make ladies love me? Because it's very important for me in my life.
God, I don't know.
No help for you. No help for you. But I'm starting a little bit, you know?
Just have to go with your instinct. That's all I know.
You have it or you don't have it.
The way you feel inside, but go with your heart.
Maybe that's the problem. I don't feel anything. You know? I'll think about it. I'll think about it in the future.
What I did for the beginning, you know? I was I spent a lot of time
thinking about you and how can I be so good like Billy Idol, and I came to the answer that it's not possible for me. But I copied you in a few situations, so there is one nice photo of you. Yeah. that goes with the concerts or so as a tribute to you, I put it in my show, you know. This is how my show begins every time.
Not bad for the beginning, huh?
You got the idea.
What is the greatest thing in your career, if you look back now? Is there anything that you can emphasize as the greatest moment?
I think the greatest thing was just being allowed, I mean, having an audience that lets me do this for a living. That's incredible. So I could never have imagined that when I was...
Yeah. Good. Nice answer. I wanted to ask you...
Thank you.
I wanted to ask you also about Steve Stevens. You have a very interesting relation, and it seems to me that he helped a lot in your career.
Oh, yes.
So how do you see this cooperation between the two of you?
Steve's an incredible musician. He's incredibly intelligent as well. And I just think the combination of us together is just something phenomenal in a way. And something that's another thing I could never really imagine, that we could have something as strong as we do and it would last this long. That's something that doesn't happen in music all the time.
Now, the thing that is very interesting about you is, I already said that I think that you are very honest and very open, and you spoke freely about all the things that happens in rock and roll. So is there anything that you could send as a message to young people in Serbia about rock and roll and living a rock and roll life? Does it have to be with all the bad stuff that are nearby, or you have to try it and then stop it?
I think the thing is, you have to come from a place inside yourself that's very, very true to you. And once you discover that place, that's what's going to make, that's what makes people, that's where they can understand you. That's where they kind of feel a kinship with you. And I think if you're coming from that place, that's not so easy to find. But if you do find that place as an artist, I think it helps you. It sort of feeds your artistry, gives you a platform, a place to sit, you know, gives you a background, something to hang on to. Because you're kind of never going away from yourself. You're trying to
run away,
but it's
not possible.
Yourself. And I know that can get very difficult when you get so much excitement and so much attention. A lot of that can, you have to be careful sometimes and hold on to what's true about yourself. So
what was the crucial moment in your life that made you change yourself? Because you did change yourself a lot.
Well, I love music. I love music, and it gave me a sense of freedom that other things didn't really. And then following a dream I had of being in a group and writing songs and enjoying it. And I could never have thought it went on this long. That's what's incredible. We all thought it would be over in 5 minutes, and it's amazing to still be here singing. And
oh, you're going to be here even more, believe me. I can guarantee you that one. Final question for you. What was the toughest moment in your career?
I had a very bad motorcycle accident in 1990, and I've got to say that was scary, because they were nearly going to cut my leg off, you know. But they fixed me. They could rebuild me.
And they rebuilt you well.
I got over it.
Okay, we came to the end. I promise you that I will not bother you too much, because your songs are the most important thing tonight in this show. I just want to see one more clip, and then I'll bring you to the end. Don't worry.
All right. We're now going to play the Serbian national anthem. Let's go, Rebel Yell!
Well, I just think the Serbian people have got a lot of
oomph. Oh, we do. Oh, we do. We do. So, the last thing that we're going to see tonight is Rebel Yell, performed by you and your band. Thank you very much for being my guest in these 200 episodes. And when I do the 400, you can come again.
200 more!
Yeah, thanks a lot. S Ivanom Ivanovićem za kraj, Billy Idol!
Just a song.
for you, babe. 8,000 miles for you. I'll dry my tears of pain, babe. I said a million times for you, for you, for you. I'd sell my soul for you, mama. All money to burn. Rebel yell, she cried, mom, mom.